Hello everyone, my name is Vijay and I'm a Microsoft MVP. In today's video, I'm going to show you how we can use a JavaScript library known as Tabulator, where we can display table data in table format. So if I will show you, basically this is how we can create a table very easily with few lines of code just by using this Tabulator library. In my previous video, I have explained how we can start with JavaScript, how we can create the JS file using Visual Studio Code, how we can create files or HTML files using Visual Studio Code. I'll put the link in the video description. You can have a look at this. Now, basically, what is Tabulator? This is a library. This is JavaScript library that we can use to create this kind of interactive table. And by using Tabulator, you can create a table from any HTML table or JavaScript array, AJAX data source, or even from a JSON formatted data. So these are the data sources. If you have data over there, then you can make a table like this. So we will see step by step how we can do this. And again, if you already you are using Tabulator, then you can simply ignore the video, because this is not who are experienced in Tabulator. Rather, we will see how we can use it as a beginner level, and I will make sure that by end of the video you can create this kind of interactive table by yourself. Now, so how we'll start over here? So as I said, there is a library. There will be some HTML, some data in a JavaScript array or something. So we will create an HTML file, then we will see how we can create a JavaScript array which will have our data source. All these things you will see. So now you have option, either you can go to Visual Studio Code, and for your I am using here Visual Studio Code. You can use any editor of your choice, because ultimately this is just with an HTML file with some JavaScript code we are going to write. So you can use any editor. You can even use Notepad also. Now Visual Studio Code is a free editor. I already explained in the previous video as well. So which you can use, and it will we can write the code very easily in that. So now what I'll do is, I have a folder here. You can see here, this is the folder, Visual Studio Code Demo. Within that, we will create another folder. Why we are creating another folder? Because we will make sure that our whatever the file we will add, it will be added into that folder. So I will say Tabulator Demo or example. And this is basically, we want all our files, whatever we will create here, it should be in this folder, so that there will not be any override of files or anything. Now I will open this folder using Visual Studio Code. Simply I will click over here and I'll type cmd. So it will open our command prompt. Here you just type code dot, and then it will create it will open the Visual Studio Code, and you will see that folder. So you can see here. Now here we will start it, but I already have the project, okay? And let me just show you how it is working. So if we will open here, this is actually the file. You can see here, this is just an HTML file with some CSS file reference, one JS file reference. This is for the Tabulator, and here is the code. You can see here, this is the JavaScript array, and then finally this is where we are rendering these things. So ultimately there is just one file we will deal with it, and I can run it with live server. You can see it here, this is the live server. You can see, and you can see I can filter here. If I will type like this, you can see it is filtering. You can see here I can select something like this. So we have this thing. You can see paging, it is working. And also in paging, you can see first, next, previous, last, all these buttons are there. There were times when we were working in .NET or in SharePoint server object model code. For this kind of things we have to write a lot of code, but now this is open source era, and we have a lot of JavaScript library which you can use that provide additional lot of information. By default, you can see here this setting, everything is working also. Now let me open this URL. So you can see here tabulator.info, that is the URL where all you will get the documentation, lot of examples, and I will strongly tell you or suggest you that you can go through this. So you can see clearly it is showing that this is the same thing that it is saying, create interactive tables from this data sources. And here is an example. You can see here you can even edit, you can sort, you can on any column you can filter by rows, first, next, last, these columns. And here is the code. You can see here, this is your JavaScript code, this is your div, HTML div, where we are binding everything, and then this is your JavaScript. Here is your JavaScript code. Now we will open our Visual Studio code. So you can see here, this is your Visual Studio code. This is the folder where we are going to write our file. So I will click on new file and I will create here tabulator demo, something like this. You can see here, make sure to keep the extension. That's the reason it is taking as a text file. So I just renamed it and I said tabulator demo.html. So now it becomes an HTML file. Simply put this symbol and then click on tab. So you will have your HTML file ready. Another this, I can put the title. So I will say tabulator example. And then you can see here, you have your body, you have your header part. Now to start with this, if you will check out the documentation, even here, you required to refer on the file, the JS file that we required here. And you have various options that you can start with. You can click on installation here from the left side. Also you can go through, you have options where you can install it. The easiest way that we can do here is, I will show this one, is you can use from the CDN path. So CDN path is where your JS is hosted somewhere and you can just use it. There are limitations, there are advantages of using any JS file from CDN. Let's say you are trying to give a path of a jQuery file, if you are opening any other site, if already the jQuery file is downloaded, then it will not download again. So that's the benefit you will get from if you are using CDN. So the load time will be reduced. And also you can simply go to this URL, you can download the file, save in your local system, and then you can use it. So you have both options. Apart from that, also there are other options where you can use. So this is what I was talking about, the other option. You can just download the file, you can refer it like this. You have this option. I'll show you this later. But now what I'll do is, first of all, I need to put these two things. So I will just copy here and we will put it over here. Now the moment I will save it, you can see here the HTML file is getting formatted because of this. You can see here, because of this JS CSS HTML formatter. So you can actually go here to this extension and then you can add that extension. In that case, you don't need to really format it manually. Once you click on save, it will format. Now once you have this, then the second thing, if you will see here, there is one HTML tag that is required, which is saying this one. So in this case, if you'll see here, it is saying that you use this HTML or this div tag. So basically this is the ID and this is the placeholder for the entire table. So this is what is very important. Now I have given a div here. Let me just copy that code from this example. You can see I put this div here. So I put it here. The next thing is, we need to add the script here or the JavaScript. First thing is, we'll create our data source. So in this scenario, our data source is the JavaScript array. And here is the code for that. So if you'll see here, I am putting everything under the script tag. So all our code is inside this script tag. Now there are questions. There are also, you might say that you require to add the script tag whether inside this or whether let me just have this end tag. So now you might have you might have been thinking that where I should put this script tag, because you might put it here, you might put it at the after this body tag or before this end tag. It is ideal that we should always put before this end tag of this body. Why? Because if you are using any div element inside this, then it will actually, by that time when the script code will execute, all this thing will be ready. For example, this scenario, since we are trying to access this div id inside this code, so if I will put over here, then when this code will execute, it will not find this one, so there will be the problem. So that's the reason I'm putting it before the script tag, so that our HTML is ready before our code trying to access this div id. Now, next thing is, we'll create the array or the data source. So it is simple. So I will give a name. So you can see here table data, and this square bracket will start, and here is the square bracket end. So it is pretty simple how we want to do or how we can create it. So if you'll see here, now this is how it will be. So when you will start this, you can see here, now this is how we will add your elements inside that. So the first thing is, in this scenario I am taking various columns. One is player ID, player name, price, the team, and then the joining date, like this. So you can see here, this is one element. I'll put a comma, and then again another element, then I'll put a comma, and like this. So in this particular example, so I have created, or I have taken this many items, 12 items I have taken, so that we can go through the paging thing. You can see here, now this is how it is done. Don't worry, I will write a post on this so that you can actually get the code, everything. I'll put that link in the video description as well. So you can see here, now we have this thing ready. So our data source is ready now. Once your data source is ready, if you open the documentation here, the tabular example, so what it is saying here is, next thing is, you can write like this, where you can see here var table equal to new table, and this is your HTML ID, and within that you can pass your parameters here. So what is our data source? That's the reason I'm putting data, and then colon, and then this is your JavaScript array. Layout, responsive layout if you want, you can say tooltip. Yes, like this. So first thing, and most importantly, this is where we are adding the columns. So what are the columns from that data source I want to show? Because since I have, this many columns are there, player ID, name, price, team, and joining date, I might not want to display player ID to the user. So you have to define, or you can define, what are the basically the columns that you want to display here. So you can see, so first thing what I'll do is, I will copy this much. Let me just copy the entire code here, and then we will go through one by one. So I will go here. So everything inside the script tag, that's the reason I'm putting it over here. So we have everything in the, entirely everything under the script tag. So according to our HTML tag, I put players here, because my div ID, the ID of this one is players. So that's the reason I put it here, players. Next thing is, there are certain parameters that you can pass. So the first one is, if you can see here, there is height parameter, which I am saying 220. Based on that, it will actually, your height will be there for that table. So if let's say I will put 220, but there are more data to show, then it will, the scroll bar will come. So when you will scroll, you can see all the items like this. And next thing is the data. So what will be your data? From where your data will come? In this case, it will come from here, whatever you have created here. So I took this name, and then we put it here. The next thing is layout. So when you do layout fit column, it will actually take the entire page, and since it is responsive, so you can actually, you will not feel a static table like this. When you will, the size will, you will reduce, it will come responsive as well. So if I'll actually now let's open in with live server. So you can see here I open in live server. So you can see here now I opened in live server, and if I will actually minimize it, you can see here you can see it is responsive. So that's how it will work. And next thing, let me just put over here in the side. And the next thing you can see here, for the pagination, you have to put, first of all, pagination is local, and then pagination size, what is the size. In this case, if you'll see here, I put 5, I can put it here 8, you can see here. And once you save this, you can see here, I will say Control S, and now you can see here, it actually added 7 rows instead of 5, and you can have 2 columns. As I said, since the height is 220, that's the reason you can see scroll is coming here. If you will make it to, let's say, 420, and you will just save it here, you can see here this still space is there. So maybe I'll put to 320. So you can see here like this, and you have now, you will not have any scroll over here. And next thing is tooltip. So in this case, if you will see here, now when I put a tooltip, it is showing the player price in crore, let's say. So it is 1715 like this. And most importantly, you can see the column. I'll come back to the column. You can see here. So this is how you can use the tooltip here. There are lot of settings are there which you can use. Now we are coming to the columns thing. So the columns is here you can do some additional settings for each column also. For example, particularly on this case, if you'll see here, there is filter, one filter condition over here for player name, and for player price there is nothing. For team, if you'll click on that, you can see here there is a radio drop down kind of is opening, and I can select something and it will actually filter. For joining date, there is nothing over here. Now that's what you can also do additional settings for the columns. Now first thing is you have the title. So what is the title that you want to show, whatever it will come over here. So for the kind of the table header, so, and the field name, which field you want. This is your field from that array that you have defined. And next, sort. So it will sort based on string. So because we have this player name is string, so similarly for price it is number, because that is a numeric. And similarly, the team, it is string, and the joining date, it is actually date time, so it is date. So the sorter parameter will take what is the data type for which you want to sort it. And then width, so you can put actually width, or it will take the, if you will not put the width, it will take automatically. Now the header filter is quite important, and it is actually different from different columns. Now for the first column, it is a string, that's the reason I put a input. So input means it is a text box which will open where I can put something. So that's the reason I put header filter and then input. So if you will see the second one, we didn't put the header footer, but there is another thing that we did here is origin formatter. So the formatter is progress here. That's the reason you can see here, you are able to see the color. There are a lot of other formatters are there. I think if I'll put star, you'll be able to see stars over there instead of this kind of formatter. So you have the options that you can select. Now next thing is the team. So in this team, if you will see here, I have different teams. For example, this is RCB, MI, CSK, RCB, so Kings, Cakes, IP. So these are various teams. So basically, these are the IPL teams that I took. And here if you'll see, these are values which you can take as a drop down. That's the reason in this case, I said header footer is true, header filter. And then the parameters that we are taking, we have to pass in this kind of key value pair. So RCB, and I said RCB, MI, MI, KKR, KKR. But you can put all other things. For example, now you can see here it has 3 values. If I will just copy one and I will add over here. So I will say SRH and I will take SRH. So once I've saved this, you can see here it will automatically, you can see here now SRH came here. So you can select, you can see the values as well. So this is how you can also put header filter pens, and it has different values. Instead of just the text box, you can also take drop down here. So, and the last one, you can see here, there's a row click function we have taken, and you can get everything on this based on the column value, whatever you have selected. For example, if I will click over here in this, you can see here row 9 is clicked. Because we are displaying in the alert box row get data and dot player ID. So basically this is how you can get the values. For example, in this case, I will take player name. So you can see here. And if I will, in this case, if I will click, then it will give you the player name. So this is how actually you can get the data from this particular table. This row dot get data and then dot your property, whatever the column you want to get this, but make sure that you will give this column ID or the column name rather than this is the header. So basically you have to give this field. So this is how you can work with this tabulator grid, but or the JavaScript library. I would suggest, highly recommend this. You can go through, there are a lot of examples are there, lot of documentation they have. So you can see here table layout, formatting, pagination. So it has all these things. So that if you will see here, there is a property which is known as resizable rows. And if you will select, if you will just copy here, and you can actually put it, you can come here, you can just put a command there and put it. Now once you put this resizable rows, in fact by default this is true. So when you will actually, now when you will open this one, you can actually resize your columns. So this width, and you can see here it is resizable. And if you'll make it false, then you cannot do that. So there are various properties you should go through. And I hope now you can use this tabulator JavaScript library to create this kind of interactive table. If you want similar kind of videos, then subscribe to our YouTube channel. You will get a lot of free videos on SharePoint, also Office 365, your JavaScript, jQuery, and Power Platform, SPFX, a lot of things you will get on that. So thank you and have a nice day.